Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series 102 Continuous. This is the 9th video on regex. In this video, we'll see how to parse configuration from Cisco router with all the logics what we have written in the previous 8 videos. So in the previous video, we have seen how to parse static route configuration, but we were reading complete configuration from a text file. You can see here we were not initiating any SSH connection to the device and parsing it. We were reading the text file and doing all the parsing. So let's run it. So you can see here, I'm parsing all these details from that particular text file. Now let's see how to initiate SSH and parse it. So here I already have a script which initiates SSH. So let's compare both. Here, this is I'm using Parameco for initiating connection and time for adding some delay. Then getpass we are not using. I have hard coded the password, but it is best practice to use SSH key for authenticating with device so that you don't have to hard code or enter password while communicating with device. Then this is regex library, and then here I'm using pprint for pretty printing certain output, some of the dictionaries. And here if you see the regex logic, it is going to be almost same in both cases. You can see for host name it is same and domain name it is same. Only difference comes when we have next line. For example, if you see this netconf yang, so in the text file we just have to give only slash n, but here when we interact with device we have to give additional slash r, the carrier return. And for username again it is same. And in case of interfaces, let's have a look. So you can see here we have only slash n, but here in SSH connection you can see we have given slash r slash n. So here also you can see additional slash r. And this is also same interface properties pattern. Both logics are same. Here I'm just giving group names, that's all. And then again for default route, you can see here for text file it is having only slash n. And here I have slash r slash n. And default route, it is same because we are not validating till the end of the line. And here I was reading the file using with open method. Here I have devices configured as dictionary with its credentials. And then I have a function here for initiating SSH connection, and here I am passing all the variables, host name, username and password from this dictionary, and using Parameco for initiating SSH, executing show run command. Then when it comes to the matching logic, you can see that is also going to be exactly same. So you can see here both are same, domain name match, then product ID match, then netconf, then username, then default route. Here default route is after interface, but the logics are same. Then interface match, all these I have explained in the previous videos. And then here I'm handling some of the exceptions like Parameco authentication failed exception and parsing logic error and parsing logic attribute error, and all the other exceptions I'm just giving a generic message saying that connect to the device. If you want, you can even control in granular level by giving multiple exceptions. Now let's try running this script, which uses SSH. So let me initiate connection to the lab CSR device. Yeah, you can see here it is parsing the output from device. It is initiating connection and parsing the output. To verify that, we will try adding one more interface here. I'll create another username also. Here you can see I have only two user and two interfaces with IP. So let's try running it again. So you can see here, it has added another user and interfaces with IP. Gigabit 3 also added, and you can see here the IP address details of Gigabit 3. Similar to that, even you can initiate connection to the DevNet device. Yeah, you can see it is passing that configuration as well. And for IP address logic and all, even you can optimize all the logic here and reuse it. To simplify the script, I just given it in this format /d/.. And all I have explained that in the previous video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. In the upcoming videos, we'll see some of the FortiGate firewall automation. Thank you.